In this video, I'll discuss the ionization energy. First, I'll define this ionization energy, typically given in units kilojoules per mole, that is, the amount of energy per mole of elementary substance. And then how much energy is required to remove an electron. That's what we're talking about. And if it's per mole, of course, it would be on that amount of energy to remove an electron from every one of the atoms in a mole of the substance, and 6.02 times 10 to the 23rd atoms would be one mole of a certain element. Okay, so this amount of energy to remove an electron. Well, before we get into the particulars, we're asked to put these in order of increasing ionization energy. We're given some electron configurations of three atoms. So before I get into why it is that they would have different ionization energies, let's just identify these atoms. So we've got two electrons plus one electron. These superscripts that look like exponents are the number of electrons in each subshell. So I've got an atomic number of three. 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 electrons, and that corresponds to the element lithium. Next we have 2 plus 2 plus 6 plus 1, and that corresponds to an atomic number of 11, or sodium. And then 2 plus 2 plus 6 is the atomic number 10, or neon. Now, neon is an inert gas, so it should have the highest ionization energy, but let's take a look at why that is. First of all, if you look at an atom, if you can, with your naked eye, look at an atom, we discuss, or we kind of give this analogy of this nucleus being surrounded by these electrons, and what is happening? Well, the electrons that are farther out from the nucleus are going to be easier to pull away from the nucleus than the ones closer in. So that's just in general, so remember that. So as we go down the periodic table, those atoms that get larger or more electrons in the outer shells, farther and farther out, though the ionization energy will go down. So lithium and sodium are in the same group, so and sodium is below lithium, so sodium should have a lower ionization energy. And if you want to get academic, we can also look at these subshells here. We've got just a 2s and a 3s, and the 3s tells us that we are farther from the nucleus than the 2s, so this farthest electron. Neon has the highest. It's an inert gas. So among these three, this will have the highest ionization energy. We said that as we move down, the ionization energy goes lower. So sodium actually will have the lowest ionization energy. So I'll just put lowest of these three, not of all the elements. And lithium, I'll put right in the middle, medium. Okay, so that's just the basics of ionization energy. One more thing to keep in mind is I like this graph. You might see this in other places as well. The ionization energy along the y-axis and the atomic number along the x-axis. So as we go up in number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way up to 118 in the periodic table. So we start with hydrogen right about here. I'm not going to put a scale here, but let's say hydrogen is there. And then we shoot up to helium, the inert gas. And then we shoot down. Number 3 is lithium right here. And we shoot down like that. So this is lithium. And then we work our way up as we move along a period, that is along a row in the periodic table. We move up, dot, 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 but not quite as high as the last helium, as the last inert gas. And here we are at neon, a little bit lower ionization energy than helium. And then we shoot back down, and it's going to be just a little bit lower than the previous low. So let's sketch the periodic table, and this is what's happening here. I'm going across this table. I hit the end. I hit helium, and then I bounce down to lithium. And then I went across. I'm going to hit neon. And then I'll go back to the next one. That's sodium. And then so on. So that's what I'm doing as I'm increasing in atomic number in this direction. So this is what happens as we go through each period. We get a higher ionization energy until we reach a noble gas, an inert gas, and then it shoots down again. That one is argon, it's the next inert gas. And it shoots down just a little bit lower. It's not going to go negative here. I'm not going to get too close here, but it shoots down a little bit lower than the last element from group one. And that's how this works, ionization energy. I hope that those basics were helpful as a start. If you did find this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.